Cool that you guys are still working together. I mean, how does that feel to have coach, Coach Habib with Coach Javier? The student becomes the coach with you.
Well, he's becoming the coach with me, and he's going to be the bigger coach at one point or another because he has more love and more passion to watch the guys and make sure they're doing things than I do. I mean, I'm kind of the burning light that's burning bright, but it's dimming. He's burning brighter than ever, and he's such an unbelievable coach that, I wouldn't doubt. Soon, people call him the greatest coach of all time, too. Becoming the GOAT to the greatest coach of all time, I can 100% see Habib being that person because, his love for his guys, his love for training, and still to this day, Habib, people may not realize that, but Habib right now, still, if you ask me, can Habib beat who and who right now? I said he can beat them all right now. Still, Habib just get ready to go. I say, hey. If he wanted to fight next week, he can fight next week. I mean, he's in shape all the time. That's something that I get privileged to see. And the only thing that's different about Habib now than before is before no one can win a round except Islam here and there. Now he lets the guys win a lot. He lets them when he spars with them. He lets them win so they can get better. But before when he was fighting, you are not getting it. You're getting your ass whooped, or you're getting handled properly. Not whooped on, but you definitely know you were being handled. The only challenge, the super challenge, was always Islam. Islam was always a super challenge for Habib. But to this day, right now, like I said, he could still reign over everybody if that's what he wanted to do. But I seriously doubt he would ever decide to do anything other than what he's doing now. He loves coaching. He loves promoting Eagle Fighting Championships. He's gone all over the world with it. He just went to Kyrgyzstan, I believe, or one of the Stan countries, and he
For
had over, I
Fightland.
think he had 10,000 people come watch. He met the prime minister of that country, and hey man, he's on the rise, huge. Eagles Fighting Championship is becoming a very prominent European league and even the Middle East promotion. Fantastic, and I don't see him changing what he's doing. I don't see him deciding that, oh, I'm gonna big money fight or anything like that. I just see him continuing doing what he's doing, being involved in business ventures that he gets offered all the time. I mean, his brand is gold, so anybody gets attached to him, it's a great thing. Look at us, our podcast
Yep.
is doing fantastic
Thank you, Habib.
as a podcast because of Habib, straight up.
Right.
Straight up, we get a lot of fans coming on board because I'm his coach and I'm still active with him, and people want to hear inside scoop on Habib and all the fighters because no one else as a coach has that, and I do. So, and I realize that, and I realize that the fans are coming to hear things about who's the next guy from Eagles MMA. I mean.